So once a pathogen does make it into our body, our immune system uses what are called generalized internal defenses. So I'm going to use this analogy throughout this lecture where the pathogens are bad guys and our immune system is like a police force and we're trying to fight the criminals, find the bad guys, and our generalized internal defenses are going to be the general response. We're looking for anyone who's committing a crime, not specifically looking for specific pathogens. So we describe the generalized internal defenses as innate, and innate means you're born with these things. So your body can do this right away. And we have two parts to it. We can attack all non-self cells. So remember that every cell membrane for every cell in your body has unique proteins sticking out that are unique to you. And your immune system sort of uses those as an ID, which cells belong, which ones don't. And they can check the cells that move through, like a bacteria, a fungus, a virus. And if they don't have those self proteins, they're going to be killed. They're recognized as something that shouldn't belong. These group of self proteins are called your major histocompatibility complex. And again, they're unique to each of you. This is why your immune system can reject organs, actually attack a transplanted organ, because it doesn't recognize the major histocompatibility complex. The attack is done by large white blood cells called lymphocytes. Cyte refers to cell. There are many different kinds of white blood cells that are going to work throughout your immune system, and we're going to talk about a couple of those. The macrophages, these are large white blood cells that circulate through the bloodstream and look for non-self. So think of these as your neighborhood police officers. They're looking for individuals that don't seem to fit. They're going to pull them over, check their ID, and if they're not supposed to be in that area, they're going to get taken away. They're not looking for a particular individual. There hasn't necessarily been a crime committed, but they're just checking to make sure everything is safe. So macro means big and phage means to feed. So these are the large feeding cells, and they're just going to engulf any non-self cells and destroy them. We also have the natural killer cells, and these are going to do the same thing. They're going to be checking IDs, they're going to be looking for non-self, but rather than moving through the bloodstream, they're going to sit in the lymph nodes and sort of check IDs. So this would be a little bit like setting up a checkpoint and pulling all the cars over and just checking everyone's ID. And between these two, you can catch a lot of pathogens that end up in your body. This video you can watch at the end of this little segment is sort of an interesting aside about your major histocompatibility complex and some of the evolutionary implications. So I hope you enjoy this little sidelight about t-shirts and humans being able to actually smell someone else's major histocompatibility complex. The second part of the generalized internal defense is to respond to damaged cells. So if your house is being robbed, you're going to call 911. If a cell is under attack by a pathogen, they're going to release proteins like histamines that alert the immune system that they need help. And so this triggers a full immune response. One of the things it does is cause inflammation. That's a swelling of the area, and that's because the capillaries become leaky. So they actually let more liquid out of the circulatory system. And you might ask, why would they do that? Well, especially those big white blood cells, the macrophages, we need them to get into the tissues. We need them out of the circulatory system and into the tissues, and leaky capillaries will help that. Fever. This is when your body raises the overall body temperature. The idea here is that it's going to slow bacterial growth. It's going to denature some of those bacterial enzymes, and it's also going to speed up the immune system. It's going to get those macrophages to the site where they're needed more quickly, as well as other responses. So most of you have heard the word histamine with antihistamine, and antihistamine would reduce these things, right? It would reduce inflammation. And the main time you take antihistamines, we'll talk about this in a little bit, is when you have an allergy. So essentially, an allergy is when your body's overreacting to something that's not a pathogen like it is a pathogen. So one of the things I want to point out here is that a number of the things that happen when you are sick are because of your immune system. Your immune system is causing the fever, your immune system is causing the inflammation, and that's trying to help your body recover. You just don't feel very good while all these things are happening. So these are your generalized internal defenses. We've got the beat cops moving through your system, looking for non-self cells, and then a response to send help when cells are under attack.